Hi guys, Blake here today, Lilley's Landing Resort and Marina on the one and only Lake Taneycomo. It is, actually have no idea what day it is, to be honest with you. 14th maybe, 15th. How about the 15th? It's the 15th of August. A Thursday, and I'm gonna do the one cast for you today. Make sure I got my depth set right here. Ooh, just about. We're gonna go with it. I've got Sculpin and Ginger with a brown head 1/32 ounce jig. And I have that tangled in my zipper on my life jacket. There you go. A little medium size carrot float with a toothpick to stop it. We've got that on the fly rod today. This here is a custom built 5-weight rod. In the trophy area, I am right across from the golf course right now. The new gravel bar poking out from the little creek coming out of the golf course there. I've been off of work from the dock for the last 2 days. I had a guide trip yesterday. We started at 10 a.m., came up here to start. And we probably missed about 20 bites in the first 2 hours. And then we went down below the trophy area and fished from the Sasquatch statue to the boat ramp. And probably, I think we caught 5 there. And then we went down all the way to Cooper Creek Flat and put a pink power worm on and probably caught another 10. So there were a lot of stalkers down there at Cooper Creek. There wasn't a lack of bites the first 2 hours, it was just how fast they were biting. It was tough to get them in. Very foggy this morning. It's probably about 8 o'clock in the morning now. Yeah, it's 8:06. It's just about as foggy as it could possibly be at the moment. When you're driving up the lake in it, it looks like you're staring into a static TV. Alright, no fish on the first cast. I put this color on just because I tend to always throw the same thing. I wanted to put something else on and see if it worked. But if not, if we don't get a bite here soon, we're going to put either a black jig on or a yellow megaworm. because those two things have definitely been the best for me. Face the camera the other way and get the nose of the boat going downstream here, because I want to cover some ground. Oh, it's kind of one of the keys to when you're fishing with the water off. If you know your fly's good, which most of the time a black or sculpin and ginger jig is good, and you're not getting bites, then you just need to change location. So we'll accomplish that today by slowly moving downstream. A couple more casts with this jig and then we're switching. The other rule about a color or a fly is 10 casts. If you get a bite in 10 casts, you either need to change your fly or change your spot. So I'm slowly moving the boat downstream at the moment and we still haven't had a bite, so it's about time to change the fly. Time to change the fly. We'll go with the yellow mega worm there. actually just tied this mega worm up. Got some split shot in here. Tied it on a micro jig head. And of course, my only option, so it's gonna have to work. Oh my goodness. How do you even? Huh. That is a tiny piece of split shot. It's not even enough to hold a fly under hardly. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it's working. Come on. Do what?
Magic fly.
Yeah, I know.
Good.
Just a smaller cream colored mega worm. Okay. I literally just untangled that fly rod tip. Somehow. In the midst of talking to Brett Rader. I was thinking I'd get out here nice and early this morning for one cast and that the bite would be good. And this just had to go and prove me otherwise. Try going just a smidge deeper here. can't exactly make it out, but it sounds like John Sappington is giving instruction right below me on how to keep tension on a fish. I could be wrong, but that's what it sounds like. And this bobber is killing me right now. Indicator bobber. Why does it keep tangling? I'll be honest, when I tie my mega worms at home, I like them to be like an 80th ounce. I like for it to be a little heavier and sink down faster. This is just what I could find in Phil's office, you know, pinch. Oh, there's one. You get to see what a fish looks like today. I'm starting to get a little worried. Anyway, that's why I added that split shot to this mega worm, because it is like 125th ounce instead of the 80th ounce. I was right. No, that was John Sappington right below me. These fish are certainly not hot to trot this morning. Try the black jig. I think at this point it's a matter of the fish aren't really eating up here versus which thing we put on. has been the case most mornings for the last month. From 6 a.m. to 8 a.m., they bite really good up here, and then the next couple hours after that are usually pretty slow. On and just see if it changes anything. However, I don't think it's going to. Shall see. shot I put on there might be too heavy for this jig. Looks like the indicator is going to keep floating for us. That's good. Really not impressed with the bite up here right now. Might turn the camera off and go downstream. I did just have a bite. Go downstream and see if there's any fish biting down there. We'll be right back. Alright guys, we're gonna fish for just a little bit longer. We're down here a couple hundred yards below Fall Creek Marina. Oh, still got the black jig on. We're out here in the middle fishing towards the bluff. Took an oxygen reading, sitting right at pretty much 4 parts per million, which is not great. Not terrible, but definitely not great. Oh, there's a fish. Hey, Cody. One 32nd ounce black jig, 7.5 foot deep. Well, that was our first cast after coming downstream. That's a lot better than we did the last 20 minutes. Come on, bud. Every time you do that, you make it hard. probably be worth going down to Cooper Creek today. There was a lot of stocker fish down there yesterday afternoon. I have a feeling they probably have not moved very far. Birds are noisy today. Blue jay there. Been just dumb luck catching one on the first cast after I came down here. think I'm going to call it there. Thank you guys for watching today. Like and share us on Facebook. We'll be back again tomorrow.